Hello, in this video I'd like to talk about FRACTRAN. FRACTRAN is an esoteric programming language developed by John Conway in order to study generalizations of the Collatz conjecture. For this year's Summer of Math Exposition, I've developed an interactive that will hopefully guide you through the process of learning how to program in FRACTRAN, and eventually convince you that this programming language is in fact Turing Complete. So let me just show you a really basic program and we can run through its operation. A program in FRACTRAN is a list of fractions, and it takes in as input a natural number and hopefully spits out as output another natural number. It might also never halt. It could go into an infinite loop or some other sort of infinite series of states and never give us an answer. Let's say that we feed the number 160 into this program. What we're going to do is we're going to take this number and we're going to find the first fraction in the list that we can multiply it by to still get a natural number. In other words, we're looking for a denominator among these fractions that divides evenly into 160. So we go through fraction by fraction, and it turns out that the first fraction works. 160 is divisible by 4, so we can multiply it by 3/4 and still expect to get a natural number. We call this current number the program state, and it stores all of the information that the program is trying to keep track of. We now try to apply our list of fractions again, this time to the number 120. What is the first fraction in the list that we can multiply 120 by to keep it a natural number? Well, again, 120 is divisible by 4, so we can multiply this number here by 3/4 to get 90. And now the program state is 90. We apply this again. Now we take 90 and we look for the first fraction in the list that we can multiply 90 by to keep it a natural number. 90 isn't divisible by 4, so it's not this fraction. 90 is divisible by 9, so it's this fraction. And so we multiply 90 by 14/9 to get 140. 140 happens to be divisible by 4, so that's the first fraction again. And 3/4 of 140 is 105. We now apply this process again. 105 is not divisible by 4, not divisible by 9, not divisible by 2, but it is divisible by 5, so we can multiply 105 by 2/5 and get our next number. Yet again, we go through our list of fractions and we look for the first one that we can multiply 42 by. 42 is not divisible by 4 or 9, it is divisible by 2, so we can multiply by this fraction here, and that gives us 231. Now, 231 is not divisible by 4, not divisible by 9, not divisible by 2, and not divisible by 5. If we multiply by any of these fractions here, we're not going to wind up with a natural number. When that happens, we say that the program halts and outputs the current program state. And so when we input 160 into our program, it outputs 231. Let's try another input. What happens if we input 20 into our program? That can be multiplied by 3/4 to get 15. 15 can only be multiplied by 2/5. Now the first fraction we can multiply by is 11/2. That gives us 33. And now we can't multiply by any of these fractions here. And so on input 20, our program outputs 33. I don't think that there's an input that will cause this particular program to go into an infinite loop, but it's entirely possible to write programs that always go into infinite loops or sometimes go into infinite loops, just like it's possible in any programming language. So I'll link down below in the video description to my FRACTRAN interactive. I hope you'll give it a try, and I hope that you'll learn something from it. My goal is that the levels will slowly build up your understanding of FRACTRAN to the point where you can program fluently in it. So in particular, let me know if there are any levels that you feel are too easy or too hard, if the difficulty curve isn't quite tuned properly. That sort of information is very helpful for me. So this here is what the FRACTRAN interactive looks like. Each of these buttons is a separate programming puzzle. starting with a very simple program, asking you to create a program that when you input 2, outputs 3. Here under input device, you can type in your program. Instead of typing in a program that works, let's type in the sample program from earlier in the video. As you can see, it will confirm the list of fractions that you've entered. And you can even enter some formulas using multiplication and powers, although you're not supposed to use parentheses. You can see a full list of instructions by checking the Show Instructions button, and it'll show you some valid syntax. Notice that in the denominator, technically you are supposed to put parentheses here, but because of the way that the parser is set up, that you cannot use parentheses around denominators. And your numerators and denominators should be products of numbers and powers of numbers. I've also added an experimental math quill entry box. This uses the math quill math entry system and my own personal parser to turn that into a list of fractions. Here you can enter your fractions as a comma separated list, but you need to be a little bit careful. MathQuill is perfectly fine to have commas throughout an expression, and so you'll want to avoid having commas in the numerator and denominator. You'll have to use the right arrow key to break out of, just like you break out of exponents, to break out of fractions, so you can put commas between the fractions. And just like with text entry, you can enter these as either numbers or expressions, including exponents and products. And it will tell you down below both what it thinks you entered and also processed forms to make sure that the internal processing is working correctly. Once you think you have a correct solution to the programming problem set before you, hit the Test Solution button, and this will try running the program on appropriate inputs. So this will try running the program on input 2. Again, the goal is to turn that 2 into a 3, but of course this program here, the input 2 gets turned into an 11, so that fails. You can also see what happens with the program when you run it on various other inputs, such as 160. And it will show you both the list of numbers and also highlight which fraction gets used at each step. You can also play an animation that walks you through the process. So again, I hope you enjoy this project. I would really appreciate feedback. You can provide that either on the itch page or in the YouTube comments for this video. I hope to make a few more videos about FRACTRAN, both a walkthrough for the entire game, if you'd like a more lecture-y demonstration that FRACTRAN is Turing complete, and also a discussion of the consequences of FRACTRAN being Turing complete. So thanks for watching, and I hope that you'll join me for those.